Hello and welcome back to all revenue management students here. Today, another exercise, this time about forecasting. Here you see the key to the first exercise I presented to you. I'm going to go through the formulas with you step by step so you know how I achieved the results. If you remember, on top here we have the historical forecast from 2016. Remember, we have 130 rooms. And in 2016, we need to be aware that it was a leap year, meaning we had 29 days in February, which is quite important once we're going to start calculating that column here, which is linked to February. All right. And when we're making the new forecast for 2017, now adjusting it, we again have obviously the same number of rooms, 130 every single day, giving us a total, if we're multiplying this with 365 days, of 47,450, because in this year February has only 28 days. That's something we need to consider in the calculation. Okay, now how have I done it? We know that it's given the situation that with the airline route with cancellation of flight schedules, we expect a decrease of 5% of visitors to our city, our destination. So we need to put that into our forecast, into our numbers, so we can have a proper reflection on the total year from January to December. First thing I've done, I splitted the room night section into two. On top here, you can see I've used only one gray column for room nights. Here, I decided to split it. Why? First, I want to simplify the 5% in change, so 5% drop. And then I'm going to calculate total room nights. Okay, so you can see here in this formula that I have taken the figure from last year January minus the group room nights, because we only want to focus on individual guests in this particular section, and then I multiplied with 0.95%, because the 5% drop is also equaling only 95% of what we have achieved. So that's why it's the easiest way for us to calculate it, instead of writing just minus 5% here. That is not correct. Okay, so we need to turn the formula around in this particular scenario. Once we have calculated this figure, we are then able to establish the total number of room nights by combining the group room nights plus the room nights that we have just calculated here on top. And we know the total number of room nights for the month of January. And then we can just keep dragging the formulas along, so we will know the total number of room nights that we are forecasting now for this particular year. Okay, for the room revenue, we're going to be just calculating, as before, the total number of room nights that we have just achieved with the ADR, okay? We're going to copy the ADR, so the pricing and rate strategy from 2016-2017, which is why you can see that the cells are all the same. You can just copy that over, and we're going to try to achieve the same pricing strategy here. So that's why in this cell here above in yellow, we now know our new forecasted room revenue based on a 5% drop in room nights with the same ADR than last year. So this entire line, you can just drag the cells. For RevPAR, we're going to calculate it with the known formula. Okay, we can go with ADR and occupancy percentage if you like, or you can go with room revenue divided by total number of rooms available in a year, whichever is more convenient for you. Occupancy percentage, we're going to be calculating on the cell that we have had before. And then it's going to be 130 rooms times 31 days in the month of January. Very important. So again, pay attention to February, 130 rooms times 28 days. And then we're going to apply the room night cell above here divided by that. Okay. For March, again, we're going to calculate with 31 days. April, we're going to follow with 30 days, etc. So here you need to adjust the formula manually for every month, depending on the number of days. That's the tricky part here, to achieve the occupancy percentage. Now, if you're going with ADR and occupancy percentage like I did, you use the ADR and occupancy percentage for the RevPAR cell, and then you can just drag along the formula until here. Again, remember, weighted averages here at the end for totals, okay? Group room nights, then obviously it's a given, depending on the figures that we have calculated here on top. For the totals, okay, room nights, we can just do a simple sum, as we can always do. Room nights and revenue can always be summed up in total. Okay, weighted average, again, please, for the ADR. So room revenue divided by total number of rooms occupied or estimated forecasted in the year of 2017. Also, remember to do the same for the RevPAR. So, the average ADR with the average occupancy for the RevPAR and average occupancy, you need to calculate the total number of rooms that you have in a year over the total number of rooms occupied. Group room nights, just the total sum as well again. Nothing special here. So, we've done our forecast now for 2017, keeping in mind that there's a 5% decrease in tourists coming to the city, so a 5% drop of room nights. When we're doing the actual year and forecast comparison, again, we're going back to the actual differentiation in valuables and figures and then the growth percentages as well. Okay, we've done that already in the KPI section, but here we're going to apply it for forecasting. So, first, we're going to focus again on the gray lines for total room nights. So, we're going to find out the difference. So, obviously, it has to be a negative value because we know we're dropping 5%, which is why we need to obviously take this cell with this cell to achieve this one here. So, in January, it's going to be minus 318 room nights. February, exactly the same. You can then just drag along the formula. And for February, you get 94 in negative, etc. Right? Total, again, we're going to compare the totals again. So, this cell with this cell to get the total here. Room revenue exactly the same. We're going to compare revenue from 2016 with 17. And obviously, there has to be a negative as well if we're dropping room nights and we're therefore also losing revenue, even though we're keeping the same rating strategy, a minus of 57,620, 36, 37 cents, excuse me. Again, we can then just drag along the formula. And we're going to compare again totals as well here at the very end to compare 2016 and 2017. ADR, we can put in zeros, okay, because we're applying the same rate strategy. However, here at the end, in the average ADR over the year, there's a slight change, okay? And for RevPAR, we're going to do the same again. We're going to be comparing this RevPAR to this RevPAR, the difference, in order to find out the variation over the entire years. Again, it's going to be a negative one because we're also losing revenue. So RevPAR development here cannot be positive. For the total, we're doing exactly the same again. We're going to be comparing RevPAR 2016 with 2017. Occupancy, same scenario once more. We're comparing the occupancy percentages of 2016 with 2017. Has to be a negative as well because we are dropping room nights. We're losing room nights. So occupancy percentages across the months, across the year also has to be negative. Number of room nights for groups, exactly the same as well. We're comparing 2016 with 2017. We're obviously here losing 275 room nights for the groups. Here again, we're going with the total 2016 with 2017 to get the total down here. In the last table down here, we're going to compare that as a growth percentage. Okay, if room nights here are negative, we're losing. Obviously, the percentage in growth has to be negative as well. The same for room revenue, the same for RevPAR, occupancy, and room nights in groups as well. So, how do we express this as a percentage? We're going to compare the figure of 2017 with the figure of 2016, and we're going to just deduct it from one in order to achieve the percentage because I already have formatted this particular cell as a percentage. We can just drag along the formulas. We apply the same then for revenue, RevPAR, occupancy, and group room nights. For the totals, here always if it's a negative across the year, it has to be a negative at the total as well. Room nights, revenue, RevPAR, group room nights, and also occupancy percentage. Again, we're going to be comparing the totals 2016, 2017, minus one to achieve the percentage. Down here, you see then my analysis of the strategy, meaning what actions we expect the revenue manager to take. I'll let you read this on your own. If there's obviously a loss in room nights, we need to be able to counteract on that. So the strategy should be basing on achieving a 5% balance.